कितना दिन क्या काम है? सेवन करना
Completion reports and the speaker is VVA Padmarao, IRAS, retired IRAS officer. He has been additional director of Sutara Accident Mobile. Mr. Padmarao has been serving as a guest faculty in several of the training programs of this academy. He is a fellow member of the Institute of Cost Accountants of India, which has been now redesignated as the Cost Management Accountants of India. He also holds an MBA degree in finance. Swagunavam has varied experience in railway accounts and finance, besides being a guest faculty in several of railway training institutes, including the National Academy of Indian Railways at Vadodara. Mr. Swagunavam has visited General Motors, USA and Canada as part of the Training of Trainers program. Mr. Swagunavam has been sharing his time, experience and efforts as a guest faculty in the Engineering Star College of India, Hyderabad, and has taught infrastructure management to MBA students. He is a guest faculty at the Administrative Star College of India, Hyderabad, as well as at Sitara Secunderabad and Girikum Secunderabad. Besides this, Mr. Padmanabhan maintains a blog called All About Railway Accounts, which is a very, very useful blog for all the aspects of various railway department examinations. We are indeed fortunate to have with us his views on today's topic, which is completion reports, which is an important topic in various railway examinations, which appears either as a short question or as a medium question with medium marks. Welcome to Sri Padmanabhan. And over
thank you.
To you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Good morning to participants.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning. Good morning. Good morning very much. We'll start the topic.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, good morning. How are you?
Good morning, sir.
Fine, sir.
Fine, fine. Presentation visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, let us start the presentation.
Sir, बीच-बीच में हिंदी भी बोलिएगा सर.
हाँ, थोड़ा-थोड़ा बोलूँगा. मेरा हिंदी को सुनके हंसना नहीं है.
Okay, sir. Okay.
सर हिंदी बोलिएगा तो समझ जाएंगे सर.
Okay.
समझेंगे इसलिए सर.
बहुत धन्यवाद, धन्यवाद, धन्यवाद.
बहुत है. Can we mute all of them, sir?
Yes, sir.
You can we will start hum shuru karenge okay sabko good morning suprabhat I'm VA Padmanabhan introduced by AK Sundar Sundar has introduced not AK Sundar and the topic today is a completion report
shall we keep everyone in mute position? Padmanabhan sir?
Yeah.
And shall we keep all the participants in mute position, audio mute?
Yeah, yeah, that is better.
Yeah.
So that disturbance will not.
Last 15 minutes we'll
we'll leave it.
Yes.
In between also they can on it if they want. Okay. The topic is seems to be simple. But it is very complicated. Completion reports is a complicated topic while working in the office. Hello. Then we will start our presentation and meanwhile I will give explanation also every stage. What is completion report? That we should know first.
Padmanabhan sir, unmute your audio sir.
Yeah.
Yes sir, now we are able to hear.
Okay. What is completion report? Completion report is a stock taking exercise and usually prepared after the completion of a work. But in between, there is another instrument called completion estimate for big projects. It also comes in May. Completion report compares the latest sanction cost, not necessarily original sanction cost. Maybe second revised estimate or third revised estimate or a completion estimate In that latest sanction cost, we compare sub-work wise and what is the reason for excess, what is the reason for saving, and total cost as actually occurred will be shown in a juxtaposition. It's like a small sheet of paper, that's all. It will not have booklet type. It is a small sheet of paper only. Sub-work wise will compare it. Reasons for excess or savings are explained, and there will be some certificates below. We will come. What are those certificates? I will tell you while the class is in progress. Why we should prepare this completion report at all? The work is already completed. Why we need it? Then another question is, how do you know a work is due for a completion report? हम कैसे जानते हैं एक वर्क को कंप्लीशन रिपोर्ट बनाना है? दो चीजों से हम जानते हैं. एक है वर्क पूरा हो गया, एग्जीक्यूटिव हैज टोल्ड यू कि काम खत्म हो गया, कि न्यू लाइन हो, डबलिंग हो, बड़ा बिल्डिंग हो, ब्रिज हो, जो भी हो, इसको कंप्लीट कर दिया. एडवाइस आ गया आपको, कंप्लीट हो गया, फिजिकली कंप्लीटेड एंड स्टार्टेड यूटिलाइजिंग इट. दैट इज वन स्टेप. सेकंड वन इज यू आर सपोज टू रिव्यू वर्क रजिस्टर्स. समय समय पर आपको वर्क रजिस्टर को रिव्यू करना पड़ेगा. देन यू आर रिव्यूइंग व्हाट हैपेंस. किसी वर्क के लिए बुकिंग नहीं है, एक्सपेंडिचर नहीं है, क्रेडिट भी नहीं है. लगातार तीन महीने के लिए बुकिंग नहीं है तो वो वर्क इज ड्यू फॉर कंप्लीशन रिपोर्ट. दैट इज वन स्टेप, दैट इज वन इंडिकेशन. नॉट नेसेसरी वी हैव टू ड्रॉ द कंप्लीशन रिपोर्ट. देन वी हैव टू एडवाइज द एग्जीक्यूटिव, आस्क द एग्जीक्यूटिव वेदर द वर्क इज कंप्लीटेड और नॉट. यू प्लीज इंटीमेट. ऐसा आप कोई खत लिखे तो वो एग्जीक्यूटिव से रिप्लाई आएगा, ये साल में बजट नहीं है इसलिए बुकिंग नहीं है, मगर वर्क तो चालू में है, वर्क तो चल रहा है, वर्क कंप्लीट नहीं हुआ. ऐसा आपको समाचार मिलेगा, खत मिलेगा. इससे आपको क्या होगा, वो दैट वर्क इज अलाइव, इट इज नॉट कंप्लीटेड. दैट इज द स्टेप. टू स्टेप्स आर देयर. वन इज आइदर द वर्क शुड बी कंप्लीटेड फिजिकली एंड यू गॉट द एडवाइस from the executive. And second one is, while reviewing the work register, 3 months continuously there is no booking for that work register, then also it is an indication that the work is due for CR. Then immediately you have to write to executive, such and such work is there from 6 mahine se, 2 mahine se, 3 mahine se, 1 saal se booking nahi hai, this work is due for CR. You submit the CR like that. If you ask, what they will say, the work is completed, they will advise you so. Otherwise they will say work is still alive but budget nahi hai saal mein, isliye hum kharch nahi kar rahe hain. Next time, next year we will ask budget and continue the work, or some other problems are there, that is why booking is not taking place. They will tell. These are the two stages in which you have to find out whether the work is due for CR. Am I clear? Then format of CR. These are brief. My first two slides mein bol raha hu, what are the steps. Format of CR the journal hai, aur steps to be taken to draw CR. Ye sab next slides mein explain karenge. Problems facing drawal of CRs. This also we have to know. Lot of problems are there. Consequences of not drawing CR. If you don't draw the CR, what will happen? That also we should know. When I was working, I was instrumental in preparing these 10 commandments. That is nothing but guidelines for drawing the CR. What is the role of accounts? Yes, we have to learn. These are the steps we have to learn. So then,
Oh.
completion report, as I told you, it is a stock-taking exercise. Early drawal of CR is important. Then you are supposed to draw the CR. 18 months, or we code says very critically, it will say by the end of 3 financial years, financial half years, at the end of 3 financial half years, after the work is completed or after the completion estimate is sanctioned. These two things we have to keep it in mind. That means in a rough way you can say 18 months is the time. Of course we have ignored partly half year in which the work is actually completed. That we will ignore. And a more than 18 months, less than 24 months time is there since the completion estimate is sanctioned. Completion estimate when you have to prepare. Similarly, 18 months or 24 months in between it will be there. From the time the work is completed, you have to submit completion estimate for all works costing more than 1 crore rupees. That 1 crore needs to be amended because nowadays even lump sum works are sanctioned beyond 1 crore. So, 2.5 crores, up to 2.5 crores you are able to sanction a lump sum works program or minimum works program at division level. So this 1 crore is not so important, it has to be revised, enhanced further. Then record keeping, this is nothing but a record keeping, work is over and work is completed, we have drawn the completion report and the competent authority is informed about the trial of the CR. It is not so easy as I am telling in this class. It requires a lot of monitoring at all levels because it is a collective effort of several departments put together including accounts. For example, a project is there in civil engineering project of double line, doubling line. Then how many departments are involved? Civil engineering is there, signal and telecommunication is there, electrification, OHE is there, and normal electrical department is there. There are four departments are involved in the same work, and you have to involve accounts department for the accounts purpose and a drawal of completion report, purse registers, bill passing, etc. So accounts department is also there. So these five departments put together collectively work. The continuous monitoring is required. Part CRs are also permitted now. Suppose in a work, if you see a project of doubling, what are the sub-works involved? We'll start from the beginning, 15-10. 15 is plan head doubling. 15-10 is preliminary expenses. 20 is land. 30 is earthwork. 40 is permanent way. 50 bridges. 60 stations and buildings. 70 plant and equipment. 80, 90 put together general charges. These are all the sub-works involved and the departments are also involved. So you can draw the completion report sub-work wise also. Preliminary expenses is the one which can be drawn immediately once the detailed estimate is sanctioned. Preliminary expenses will not be incurred after the estimate is sanctioned and started working. So preliminary expenses are meant for preparation of estimate expenditure and small expenditure like inviting tenders before the estimate is sanctioned, tender notice and a small expenditure will be there. But that will be transferred to other relevant heads once the estimate is sanctioned. Preliminary expenses are preliminary in nature. It will not be incurred after 1 year or 2 years. Once the estimate is sanctioned, it will not be incurred because the estimate itself is there for you to book the expenditure. Old works, and there are a lot of problems in old works which I will try to explain you in one or two examples. Role of divisional accountants, you call them as section officers also, designation section officer in individual departments will post them. Civil engineering, electrical, signal and telecommunication. Nowadays in hospitals are also you are having section officers. So these section officers are playing key role in drawing the CRs because they are in the spot, they are in the executive office, they will liaise with accounts and executive. They will have to help us in early drawal of completion report. Of course, full guidance from accounts department are to be provided for the divisional accountants. Coordination, cooperation, then confrontation and conflicts. Confrontation and conflicts will not help. We have to coordinate ourselves with other departments and cooperate to draw the completion reports. This is one area it requires. Format. What is the format you are having? That is called E1706 in engineering code. There is a format for completion report. It will be sub-work wise will be there. Latest sanctioned cost, actual expenditure, excess or horizontal columns I am telling, excess or savings, and remarks. Remarks, and that means reasons for, explanation for excess or savings under each sub-work. Sub-work wise totals will be there. Sub-works I have already mentioned, preliminary expenses, land, earthwork, engineering, that is permanent way. Then you will have bridges, staff quarters and offices, staff buildings, office buildings, then rent and equipment, then general charges. These are all the sub-works. I already told you latest sanction and actual expenditure will be compared in that CR. Explanation for variation should be given. There are certificates. Certain certificates you have to give it. What are those certificates? One is the expenditure is reconciled with the works register. That is the first certificate. Work is completed physically on so and so date. The second one is works registers are reconciled. Third one is all final bills are passed. All debits and credits are adjusted. All adjustments are adjusted. Then next certificate is whatever returned materials are required, they have to be returned by the departments or contractors to the railway. Then there are no audit and vigilance cases pending. There are no arbitration cases pending. Like that, there are certificates are there. These certificates are to be append, recorded there in the completion report. Then accounts will verify that and sign. The CR is verified. This requires the sanction of so-and-so. This is the format in which then competent authority. This requires the sanction of CAO. This requires the sanction of DRM. This requires the sanction of GM. This requires the sanction of Railway Board also. If they mention, the competent authority will sign at that particular place, sanctioned and with reference of memorandum of sanction reference. So this is format. This format has to be understood clearly and start doing it. Then what are the steps to be taken? This is most important. Works registers. This is the most important part because for each work, there is a works register. So each sanctioned work has got a works register. That works register is nothing but a continuous record of expenditure incurred every month, every day till the completion of the work continuously. This is a collective record of expenditure incurred against that work. This works register is prepared in form E1473. It is easy to say that, but the works registers are to be reviewed from time to time. If you don't review it, wrong bookings will creep in. What are the wrong bookings? I have seen during my service, I have seen a new line work or a doubling work has got allocation of gauge conversions, bridges allocation, and other plan heads allocations, expenditure is also crept in that. So such bookings are nothing but wrong bookings. They are to be reviewed then and there. If allocation is given wrongly by executive and bill passing or accepting that AM, JV, translating that JV into TC and accepting it, there itself mistake should have been detected, somehow not detected, and it crept into the works register. Then works register's reconciliation means not just expenditure reconciliation, totals. It is also review of bookings during the month and then see all these bookings are relevant and appropriate to the work concerned. It is not outside, some other booking is not trapped in this. That has to be noted down and necessary adjustments are to be made in the on-hand work register. Then adjustments will be there for transfer of material to and fro. That is, some materials we may have asked from other departments, other railways, other units, and we have to accept the debit. Similarly, we may have given some assistance to other projects, credit should come. Then the most important thing is final bills. How do you say final bills? Lot of problems will be there in the final bills. In many projects, final bills are not being passed. They are kept pending. Kept passed means they are not prepared at all. In some cases, measurements are also not taken. Measurement book is not recorded. Then what is the reason for this? One reason is the variations are not sanctioned. By oral instructions, the contractor has done the work. Variations are not sanctioned. It may be introduction of new item or additional item or variation in the existing items. This has to be processed by executive, not sanctioned then and there. Immediately, after the, even though some work may have commenced, though it is against rules, though some work has been done by the contractor, the oral instructions of the engineer on the spot, that should be ratified and legislated through variation statement. Some variation statements require concurrence. Some additional items, if it is NS item, non-scheduled item, this requires rate fixation and negotiations are to be done. So these things, process is not completed in many cases. That is one reason for accumulation of final bills. Second reason is, though we cannot say officially, it has to be checked up the ground reality, it may also be a reason because in the approximate measurements we are allowing approximate measurements and passing the bills. In the actual measurements are taken, there may be overpayment and the contractor is not coming forward to claim that bill or is not witnessing the measurements. So this is another area and it will lead to vigilance angle also. So these things are also important. So final bills, if they are not passed, what will happen? Large number of final bills you cannot take provisionally and call the CR drawn. Not two final bills means that is different thing. And another thing is, he may have sought arbitration while the work is still in progress. He may have gone for arbitration or court cases may be there. Because of that also final bills are pending. So these final bills is the crux of the area, that is the area which causes concern while drawing the CRs. This contributes to the large number of delays. Material at site clearance, it is only available in construction projects and rails and all, they are issued and the material at site account has to be prepared and it has to be maintained and the work is completed, the contractor has to return the material, then only MEIS will be cleared and that this MEIS contributes lot of delay in that account. Then discharge of liabilities. The discharge of liabilities has to be quick, but in most cases the work is completed. The 1 or 2 years only pink book will show the name of the work and with some funds. Afterwards, it disappears from the pink book unless you submit the revised estimate if it is required or completion estimate. Then, or you have to advise the railway board that still the bills are there, you have to ask the funds. These things are important. Liabilities are to be discharged. Take claims provisionally. Suppose some bills are pending because or some arbitrations are pending, court cases are pending, then also you can draw the CR. But taking the provisional amount into account and draw the CR. But final CR you have to draw means afterwards. You have to reopen the CR with the approved sanction of the same authority who has sanctioned the original CR. Suspense balances, if any, are there, they are to be cleared. Budget. Necessary budget has to be asked sometimes, because by booking the expenditure, by making the adjustments, by reviewing and correcting the wrong adjustments, by drawing the CR, you may end up in some asking for budget. That budget has to be sought at appropriate stage, and then only you have to draw the completion report. There are lot of problems. There are lot of problems in drawing of completion reports. Step by step, we will see. In the beginning, we should know what are all the categories of works for which you have to draw the CRs. One is construction works. Second one is open lane works. Third one is project works. And uske baad cost sharing works rehta hai. Wo ROBs, RUBs jaisa. Then maintenance of locos and wagons. Iske liye bhi deposit works rehta hai. तो उसके लिए उसको भी हम सीआर ड्रा करने का करने पड़ेगा. सो बेसिकली हमको कंस्ट्रक्शन वर्क्स हैं, ओपन लैंड वर्क्स हैं, डिपॉजिट वर्क्स हैं, कॉस्ट शेयरिंग वर्क्स और मेंटेनेंस ऑफ लोकोस एंड वैगन्स के लिए भी डिपॉजिट वर्क्स रहते हैं. उसके लिए भी कंप्लीशन रिपोर्ट ड्रा करना पड़ेगा. सो इसके लिए क्या क्या प्रॉब्लम्स रह सकते हैं, हम सामना करते हैं, इसके बारे में हम थोड़ा बहस करेंगे. In many cases, when you want to draw the completion report, you end up executive, you write letters and they come forward and tell there is no work registered with them because the work is very old one. And in the venture of offices in the executive side, the records are not traceable. Works register is also not traceable. Then how do you go about it? The accounts have to provide their copy of the works register and ask them to start working on that. Because we have got printout, the same printout we have to give it to them. Hello? We have to give the printout. And the same printout, and we ask them to work out like that and start preparing the completion report. Then no records, old works, no records. We have seen 20 years old work is still completion report is not drawn. 30 years, 20 years. Construction may you will face in the construction. Lot of works will be there, completed works. We can see physically the line is already in operation. It is started earning also money. Earnings are accrued. We are getting earnings from that line. And we don't draw the CR. It's just simply that is lethargy. Delay is due to slackness and lethargy on account of departments concerned. And also not monitoring from our side. Monitoring is also not there. That is why it requires close monitoring. So this is the old records will be there. I will come when I explain one deposit work case. I will tell you what is the problem we have faced in Royal Dacia. Final bills had to be passed, make out the list, where from you make out the list, contractor ledger, from contractor ledger, you know how many agreements are there for that project, department wise, agreement wise, you know, to prepare where the final bills are to be passed. That list you send it to executive and ask them to take up from that list. So this type of proactive role we have to play, then only we'll be able to clear the CRs. But CRs are to be prepared by executive, but we have to help them from this angle. Adjustment spending, you know well, executive knows well that transfer of materials place from and debit and credit has not been adjusted in the first instance. It have not financial transaction not completed, physical transaction completed, material used and project completed. And now, after 20 years, you want to draw the CR, the work will naturally be not found in the big bug. You have to allow funds because funds are not there, the expenditure. So this is the executive problem. At higher level only they can solve this problem. Arbitration cases, claims cases, these are the naturally every project you come across all these arbitrations. Delay due to lethargy and slackness is always known. That is why CRs are due from 20 years back. Works also are to be drawn CRs. Make out a list, we'll get all the old works and they are to be there. That is because no initiative is there. From every department has to take initiative. Lead role has to be played by accounts department because we are explaining in our fairly error report all these things is our housekeeping item. Housekeeping item, works registers, completion reports, suspense balances, audit objections, accounts inspection reports, stock sheets, all these things are housekeeping items. Nobody will take interest. Interest has to be taken by accounts. And when you are going for a meeting with executive, you take your own items of priority list pertaining to that executive with whom you are going to have a meeting. And in every DOM and in every BOM meetings, these items, stock sheets, completion reports, etc., are listed. But they come just before lunch hour. So they, many people don't take much interest, cognizance of whatever you say at the end of the meeting. So that is why the best way is when you are going for a tender committee meeting with a particular senior DN, say senior DN in Bridges, Vijayawada, or senior DN coordination. At that time, you have to take that list of CRs, list of audit objections pending from that officer. Perfect. These things you have to place before them, before that person, and start discussing. Definitely, at that time, he will show interest and results will be very good, very positive results will emerge. This is how we have to take our things also into priority area and discuss with executive. Then only some progress, tangible progress can be achieved. Monitor, that is why I am telling you, no adequate monitoring at higher levels means I am not telling no monitoring. Adequate monitoring is not there at higher levels, especially in our department we should take up. Because our deputy FNGO instruction, our senior DFM, these two are key persons, they can influence this area. They take their subject wise and officer wise list ready with them. Whenever you go for discussion, whenever that particular officer comes for some discussion with NDFM or DPFA construction, definitely these areas are to be put forth before that officer. The results will be, very good results will be forthcoming. So this is the suggestion I want to make. Still problems are there. One problem is there, staff pattern or officers are changed, the executive department. Frequently if they change, jurisdictions also if they change, jurisdiction, administrative jurisdictions change it. These things will go and take back seat, not front seat. So problems will further aggravate. Then lack of interest, lack of guidance. This can be provided. Lack of interest, I cannot generate interest. lack of guidance can be covered by trainings like this. So officers level also during working, they can motivate their staff. Whatever little doubts are there, they can clarify their doubts, and guidance can be provided by training or discussion or by collecting the information from instructions from other offices. Engineers can be called for assistance. Those who have worked in that same seat and transferred to other sections can also be taken. Their help can be taken for some time. That is, lack of guidance can be covered, but lack of interest, we cannot do anything, because the interest has to be generated from within. If the lack of interest a particular staff is showing, then we will have to show him the place and transfer that fellow from that seat. But usually you place a person in that particular area who is not so bright, who is not showing interest in office work, then only area is DIR, discipline and appeal, will come into limelight, and will have to generate interest by, at least by, there is a policy called in management, character district. For some gas is there, donkey ke mouth ke samne a carrot ko lagate hai. That carrot will move when this donkey is moving. So she cannot, the donkey cannot catch the carrot. So that is incentive, cash awards and all. Then peeche se maarte hai na donkey ko, ek lakdi se. That is called discipline and appeal rules, charge sheets and all. So this is management principle called carrot and stick. That has to be applied even in offices, in extreme cases, where generally staff are also will come to the point, come round to the point, and they will work. Most of the cases, we need not to take DR action, but some incentive has to be provided, because it is very disinteresting work. Nobody is doing it for years together, and some incentive has to be provided in the form of cash award and all. Those people have to be recognized if they have done really. And large variations, cost and sanctions is left for regularization in CR, which is a general thing, phenomenon we observe in the projects. You see the projects, the cost is increased, but it requires, it cannot be explained in CR. The percentage of excess is so much, it requires actually a revised estimate has to be prepared and sent to competent authority and get sanctioned. Then only you will have to prepare completion. When the work itself is completed, where is the question of revision estimate? Then you have to prepare a completion estimate and send it, get it regularized, then draw the CR. So these things easy to say, but difficult to implement, because the formation of field formation and headquarters formation must have changed in 2 decades old work. Who has got what you call it, interest to prepare that proposal? And if railway board asks questions, these fellows have to, current people have to ask, reply. Current people have to furnish replies. Who have got interest to do all those things? So that is why the people leave any works with a lot of excess expenditure incurred, and they don't get it sanctioned in time. This is because monitoring failure. Even in our accounts, this is a failure, because revised estimates of excess over estimate. Excess over estimate is the items are usually every quarter you report in statement of unsanctioned expenditure. This is also in appropriation account annexure. So every year you are routinely going, item wise you are not monitoring after submitting that sanction. Register of unsanctioned expenditure, the statement of unsanctioned expenditure you have submitted as a report to the railway board from time to time, but actually it is not to be ended up there. You will have to monitor each item individually. You have to monitor and then see that the excess is regularized. If that is done, it will not be left for regularization at the time of completion. This aspect has to be clearly understood by all of us. Non-realization of credits. Some projects are due to get credit because they have already, we have transferred the material to other projects and we are not pursuing that debit has to be raised against that project. And another aspect for non-realization of credits is sale of materials, whatever is the scrap is sold, that credit also has to come to that project. Credit for release remitting. These two things are to be monitored. Vigilance cases and audit objections. These two also will stop your CR monitoring. Because audit objections have to be cleared. Vigilance cases are to be finalized by appropriate authorities. Some cases go to CVC and it is against the officers concerned. So unfortunate things. Those things are to be cleared. Then only you can certify the CR. Audit objections, okay, we can pursue it. Vigilance cases are sensitive area, so this requires to be dealt at very high level, and this has to be also monitored. But we cannot help clearing the case, vigilance cases, because that is a separate thing there, separate procedure of PR and all. So these also cause problem. This is one of the problems for some projects where CRs are due, you are not able to certify the CRs. So now second question is, suppose you don't draw the CR, what will happen? What are the consequences of non-drawal of CR? This is the area we are yet to cover. Time element, that is the first one. If you don't draw the CR, what will happen? The CR becomes old, older and oldest. So oldest item it becomes, hardcore item it becomes, difficult item it becomes, nobody will be able to sort out that. So work is completed some 30 years back, track renewal also may have taken in that. So but you have not drawn the CR of original one. Maybe, so many reasons I listed, you know, they may be there, but by this time they may have been solved also. But for every problem there is a solution. If you have got a intention to solve the problem, these are the hardcore items are to be first discussed with the executive concerned periodically and mutually try to find out solutions which are acceptable and fitting within the rules. Then excess over estimates. If you leave the CR like that, excess over estimate will be there. Every time we are submitting the half-yearly arrear report, in that you are dealing it, and your quarterly statement, half-yearly statement of transaction expenditure, in that excess over estimate comes. So excess over estimate means you have allowed the expenditure beyond the estimate sanction, which you should not have allowed as an accounts officer. This is a lesson for you. We are learning this lesson, but we are not implementing. Again, new items are coming as excess over estimates. Years ago, everybody told me, in a court there is a para called 1136 para. There are 1136 clearly says, excess over estimate, how to regularize it. There are many stages they have explained. Easy steps they have mentioned, but timely you have to take, not after 20 years. So this excess over estimates, if you don't draw the CR, it will remain as excess over estimate in the, this thing, and CR will be like that. Old, when you are not drawing the CR, it becomes tracing of old records will be very difficult, because executive offices are closed. Once the work is physically completed and line is handed over to the open line, then the executive office either will be merged with some other project or it will be shifted from that place. The old records will remain still old and the antiquated, it will become and they will just fail. So old records will not be available because you are not drawing the CR in time. And it is also an ineffective indication that we are not able to close the accounts. Once you start the project, enthusiastically you have started the project, enthusiastically you are finishing, physical work you are finishing, accounts portion, executive is not doing it with as much speed as they exhibited while executing the work. This is the stage where the accounts department and executive department both should work in as a team, then they should take that item into finality. There are large number of persistence. You review, you ask the IT center, what is the, how many works are there for which there is no booking from last 3 months continuously. You ask, if you write a software program and ask in the IT center, they will give the list. The list runs, thousands of persistence are there which are not having booking for years together. Actually, they are the works for which CRs are due. But mind-blogging data will emerge from the IT center. This is the area where we have to show personal interest, keen interest, and motivate each other, executive and accounts, staff level and officer level. And then they should take this subject further, because in learning in the class helps you to know the problem, but working in the field will provide opportunity to solve that problem. That is most important. We are only learning theory here. When you go, each of you go to your office and try to take one work and help the executive to draw the CR, identify the problems, you also work with them as a team. Then you will come to know the entire thing about CRs practically yourself. One work, you want 250 people are there in this class. 250 CRs can be drawn by 1 month. You start attempting that. If you are in construction or well line division or workshop, so you attempt wherever it is possible. So each of you should volunteer yourself. If you see any DFM or DFA construction, yes, I will take up own your work like that, own your CR. One work, own it, and effectively coordinate with your level people. Then take up that with SAO level, take up at the deputy level, deputy CE level, then see the results. The results will be amazing. And you will help draw of many CRs. But that is what only one work you can take up with the permission of your controlling office. So difficult to get funds for old works. If you don't do the CRs in time, the works will become old. They are dropped from the pink book. And when you draw the CR, we have to debit the work at that time. Of course, by reappropriation rules, CAO and CPC help you to get the funds. When you are taking that CR to that stage, naturally you will get help from the DHODs and CAOs. No problem. Funds will definitely, they will have. Disputes and differences remain unresolved. There are many disputes, arbitration cases, and there are differences of opinion between executive and accounts also. These things, if they remain resolved, then also CR may not be able to. But actually, this dispute or difference, what I am referring is between contractor and administration. More pointedly, between contractor and administration. What is the dispute they have? One is dispute regarding measurements. Or measurement is the method of measurement adopted. These things they have to solve themselves. Because their measurement is an accepted matter. It cannot be arbitrated also. But it will go to court. Court has no rules like this. Court will listen. So these are the, that takes lot of time. And the disputes are to be resolved by meeting or arbitration. These things are to be taken into account while studying the consequences of non-real of non-royal of seers. There is role for us that is called role of accounts. In every area we have got role of accounts. So Varshreshthas are to be reviewed. This is most important. Reconciliation you are doing, but review means review for wrong bookings, wrong allocations, and the work, some bookings, wrong bookings will take place. These things are to be then and there reviewed. The same year at least, they should be adjusted. Then the fund problem will not be there, and the works list will be clean. Then monitoring. Monitoring is most important. We are sending, we have to take out the list of CRs due, and department-wise, designation-wise, division-wise as well as designation-wise, to take the list and start pursuing at all levels. Not by just writing the letters, but you have to pursue it at a very high level effectively. I give you an example. It used to be one FNCO construction, and that FNCO construction monitored these CRs as a personal item, and tremendous success was achieved. More than 60 completion reports were drawn during that FNCO's tenure. And what that FNCO used to do is, I was a deputy FNCO at the time, and we used to write letters, speak to territorial CE construction, because there are 4 or 5 CEs will be there. So CE construction 1, tomorrow I am coming for meeting. FNCO used to say, no, not tomorrow, day after tomorrow. Okay, day after tomorrow meeting. Used to go to that CE concern, take the list in advance. We used to send the list of items, and we send some 20 items. At least 3-4 items used to assure. Used to call his own staff and discuss one day before, and we used to have that progress. Immediately, the peculiar feature of our FNCO was at that time is FNCO used to give the date for review. So after 15 days, we will review these items. Okay. So after 15 days, exactly after 15 days, again meeting. Not this meeting in FNCO's chamber. It is in CE's chamber. So this continuously we used to pointedly at each work we used to discuss. Not number. 40 numbers are pending. 10 numbers are drawn. Not like that. 40 numbers are there. This is the list of 40. In that, what is the work you want to take up for CR? So, item number 2, 3, 4. In the minute.
यांत्रिक अभियंता मैकेनिकल इंजीनियर डिवीजन ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियर
रिपोर्टिंग इन प्रोग्रेस
डिपार्टमेंट सर दिस इज द वे कंस्ट्रक्टिव रोल दैट एपेंड शो प्लेड ट्रेमेंडस रिजल्ट्स वी अचीव मॉनिटरिंग रोज मॉनिटरिंग. That type of monitoring is required.
and FHU. FDF and FHU also can interact.